Social anxiety disorder. Now, at first glance, it's going to sound like simple shyness, but there's so much more to this. Man is the only animal that blushes or needs to, because we think about what our actions are.
Thank you.
our lives, or even face a little bit all the time. The anxiety can be so overwhelming that they literally just can't do it at all. And so they learn that the best way for them to get by is often just to avoid completely. It's just, this is just me, you know, why would I go to a doctor to try and get help with this if this is just me? There's a phrase I came across, lost opportunity. It made me sad almost thinking about that, that there are folks who just step away from opportunities because they don't even want to be in that situation. And there's this real sadness sort of saying, I really wish I'd done this earlier on because my life would be different. These are people who actually want to be able to do it. They don't want to be alone. They want to have social interaction. They crave it, but they don't know how to do it. There's a big difference between that and the true social misfit, or, you know, if you will. There is definitely a group of people who people. You know, they want to hurt other people, and they're recluses, you know, by choice because of that. The truth may be that they're absolutely terrified to engage with other people in any way. So there are a lot of misconceptions about this problem. In terms of what we see in the brain, we see in social anxiety disorder and some of the other anxiety disorders that some of the parts of the brain that are involved in emotion processing and emotion regulation called the limbic system, and part of that includes pieces of the limbic system like the amygdala and the insula, that these seem to be actually overactive in people with social anxiety disorder when they're